Hello, this is Dr. Grande. Welcome to my video on creating a box plot using Microsoft Excel. I'll be using Excel 2016 for this example, and this is the first version of Excel that has the box plot as a chart that you can select. However, it is possible to create a box plot using earlier versions of Excel, and I have another video that covers that. So I have loaded some fictitious data into this Excel worksheet. You can see column A and column B. And let's assume that these represent scores on a depression inventory. And these are t-scores, which have a mean of 50 and a standard deviation of 10. So before I create a box plot, I want to calculate some values based on these two variables, which I've simply referred to as variable 1 and variable 2. So I want the minimum, the quartile 1, the median, quartile 3, and the maximum, as well as the mean and the range of each variable. So I can use one function to calculate these five values using the same range, but a different argument at the end of the function. And that's the quartile.inc function. So I'll go into minimum and enter quartile inclusive. And the array in this case is going to be all the values in A. So starting with, I'm going to start here at the bottom, A50, and then move up to A1. And then I'm going to click F4 to make this an absolute reference, so it will not change as I autofill. And then the comma, you can see that there are five possible arguments to put in place here after the comma. The first is minimum value, and it's 0. So I'm going to put in 0 because I do want the minimum in this case. And it's 27.88. I'm going to autofill the same function all the way down and just go in and change this argument, in this case from a 0 to a 1, which will give me the first quartile. Then for median, I'm going to change it to a 2, which will be the median value or the 50th percentile. And then for quartile 3, change this to a 3, and the maximum value would be, change this argument to a 4. So the same function can give us all the values we need here. Because I have 50 values in column B, what I can do here with this function for variable 1, which is the minimum value from column A, is in the absolute reference, I can remove the dollar sign in front of the letter. I have to remove it in both places, for A1 and for A50. And then I can autofill it to the right. And you can see now it's B1 through B50. And I'll autofill this down, and then make the same changes as I did for variable 1. And I have the maximum here, and that's 4. So here we have all these values for both variable 1 and variable 2. Now to calculate the mean, that's fairly straightforward in Excel. The function is average. So for the values in column A, just be average. And I'm just going to select A50 through A1. And similarly, for the average of column B, except it'll be B50 through B1. And then the range is going to be the maximum value minus the minimum value. So in this case, 79.52 minus 27.88. I'll make the same calculation for variable 2. So it'd be 73.42 minus 22.74. These values are important to have on hand to understand the information displayed in a box plot. So to generate the box plot, I'm just going to highlight A1 down through B50, and actually start at B50, work my way up. So highlight this region and then insert. And here we have insert statistic chart. All right, and there's a little down arrow, we'll click that. And you can see histogram is available, a couple different types. I want to move down to box and whisker, otherwise known as a box plot. And I'm going to delete the chart title and the label here at the bottom. And then increase the size. To make this chart agree with the values I generate here, I'm going to right click and format data series. And you can see for the quartile calculation, it has inclusive and exclusive median. I use the inclusive median, so I'm going to switch this to inclusive median and then close that dialog. So now this box plot is consistent with my values. So now let's interpret the box plot for variable 1. You can see you have a whisker extending down, and this represents the minimum value. You can see 27.88 matches what I have here for the minimum value. Then you have this rectangle. At the bottom of the rectangle, this represents quartile 1, 42.54, and the top of the rectangle represents quartile 3, which is 56.78. This line that separates the rectangle here, that's the median. That's the median value. You can see it's just below 50, 49.72. And then this top whisker, this is the maximum value excluding any outliers. So in this case, it's 77.95, even though the true maximum you can see is 79.52. That value is considered an outlier, and you can find that here, this dot, 79.52. So how does Excel determine if a value is an outlier? Well, to understand that, we first have to understand the concept of intra-quartile range. So I'm just going to put that down below range here, IQR. Intra-quartile range. Now that's the difference between quartile 3 and quartile 1. So in this case, I can calculate it pretty easily. Take quartile 3 and subtract quartile 1. It's 14.24. Now for a value to be considered an outlier, it has to be greater than the intra-quartile range times 1.5 added to quartile 3, or less than the interquartile range times 1.5 subtracted from quartile 1. So first let me take the interquartile range, multiply it by 1.5. That gives us 21.36. And then I'm going to calculate the lower outlier cutoff, which would be 42.54 minus 21.36. So equal sign quartile 1 minus 21.36, that's 21.18. And for the upper cutoff for an outlier, it'll be equal sign quartile 3 plus 21.36. So 78.14 is the upper cutoff. So you can see we've exceeded that because we have the 79.52 value, which is here in column A. It's A7. So if I were to change this value to 78.14, you can see now there are no outliers. That's the new maximum value, and it's inside the cutoff. It matches the cutoff value, so it's not displayed as an outlier. If I were to move this to 78.15, you can see now it is an outlier. It's greater than 78.14. Now, as you can see, this chart is dynamic. It changes as I change the values. So if I were to change this value to, say, a more extreme value, say 104, you see how it redistributes the point and changes the values on the y-axis. So of course 104 is an outlier, and you can see it way up here now. So if I were to go back and reset this back to the original outlying value, 79.52, you see the lower bound here is 21.18, and the minimum is 27.88. So if I move down here to the minimum, you can see that value is in A27, 27.88. And let's say I made that 20. You can see how the graph now shifts, and the new bottom whisker is 29.09, and of course the value of 20 now becomes an outlier. I hope this video on creating box plots in Microsoft Excel was useful. As always, if you have any questions or concerns, feel free to contact me, and I'll be happy to assist you.